The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
3 seconds, 2 seconds, half court heave by Madden. It's no good. The North Union Warriors are undefeated no more as Bishop Garrigan comes out on the road and they shock North Union of a 58-53 victory. Back out to Joyce. Joyce splits down the lane, taking big strides. Got to the rack and scored. Ready-made fast break for Joyce. Joyce sidesteps. Joyce up the window. He put it down and a foul. Michael Joyce with a chance for a three-point play. And now here comes Schwab yet again. 42-39 Garrigan. Schwab drop off for Thomas and he lays it in. 12 on the shot clock. Schwab in the lane. Floats over Wallstrom. He put it in and a foul. Carter Schwab, an opportunity for a three-point play.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kemna Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
The final game before winter break for the Bishop Garrigan boys basketball team as they welcome the St. Edmund Gales to their gymnasium for this non-conference matchup. Good evening, everyone. Tyler Lance of you on Home Country Radio, KLGZ, and the Algona Radio YouTube stream is tonight. It's the 5-4 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, a team that's won 3 out of their last 4 games against an improved St. Edmund Gale team, one that only won 5 games last season but already has 3 wins this year with a 3-3 record. It's a new-look Gales team, one that welcomes the sophomore Hunter Horn onto their roster, the transfer from Fort Dodge High School, who's their leading scorer at 18.4 points per game and a great post player for St. Edmund, that is, early in the season. Meanwhile, on the Bishop Garrigan side of things, things are really starting to gel together. 3 wins in the last 4 games, the only loss being against Algona, who was a state team in 3A last season with the Golden Bears. They've won 3 conference games in a row. Now they look for a non-conference win tonight, trying to cap off that pre-winter break schedule. We will step aside for a quick timeout to talk to Bishop Garrigan boys head coach Mark Meister coming up in just a couple of minutes on KLGZ 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
PMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Getting ready for board. boys high school basketball action right now on Home Country Radio KLGZ. It's the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears against the St. Edmund Gales. And right now we're joined by Bishop Garrigan coach Mark Meister. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time once again today. If you want to start our listeners off, just a recap of Tuesday's. You guys picked up a dominant victory over North Iowa, won your third game in the past four games. So what were your overall thoughts coming out of Tuesday's game?
Well, I think after the first half, once we kind of went in the locker room and had a slight discussion about how we were playing defensively, it was a different game the second half. We had given up 15 points, I believe, in each of the first two quarters, and we went in and talked about it, and I think the boys corrected it, and we gave up 16 the rest of the way, and that was kind of our goal, to hold them under their scoring average, and at halftime, it looked like it was not happening. So for us, again, it keeps going back to that side of the ball, defending, getting out and running, and it requires, you know, a lot of talking and a lot of early rotations before they almost need to happen. We're trying to gamble that and play that so we can do those things that we'd like to do.
And, Coach, this is always an interesting time of the year for all kinds of programs just because you have the aspect of winter break coming up for the guys as well and a final game before that. So how do you feel the focus has been among the team in the past couple of practices and just overall leading up to winter break, you know, keeping the focus on basketball?
I think pretty good. I think, you know, we kind of ran the gamut of our schedule there. We had so many tough games in a row, just kind of the way everything worked out. And then once, you know, we saw a few more winnable games on the schedule, I thought, we responded well in those games, and, you know, I feel like we're hopefully going to start turning a corner here. We feel like we're starting to become the team we want to be, and I think Christmas break is going to be good for us to kind of, you know, start over on some things and recommunicate some stuff, but I feel like we're coming into Christmas break the right way right now.
And, Coach, what are some of those big areas where you feel the team is starting to make progress and starting to turn the corner on?
Well, you see in, you know, some of the games we're playing, the ball is moving more. It's not sticking as much. We've been kind of running more back of our secondary offense, and in that requires a lot more side-to-side movement. We'd like to move the ball from one side to the other side of the floor, you know, 2 to 3 times in a possession, and that makes it hard for defenses to rotate. It creates more scoring opportunities for guys. You know, like the other night, Schwab took less shots that night and had another really efficient night. He did that at North Union, very efficient night. Well, when he's got the ball and you know, guys are loading up on him, it's tough for him. When we swing it and get it back to him and now he's got space and he can operate easier, that helped him. You know, same with Michael Joyce in those two games. Those are kind of our main two ball handlers, and when those guys have it a lot, I feel like it's harder on them. So getting it to swing, getting other guys to have opportunities with the ball, and I think those other guys are helping make plays for them to free them up for them to have more efficient scoring.
And, Coach, an interesting matchup tonight as you guys host the St. Edmund Gales, and certainly a St. Edmund team that looks a little better than the one you saw last year. So overall, when you look at St. Edmund, what do you feel are some of the things that make them maybe a little bit tougher than they've been the past couple of seasons?
Well, I think they've got, you know, better players this year. One of their best kids, I believe, last year was hurt. They look like they're playing, I think, very well. I think it's going to be a very challenging game for us. They got one kid scoring 18, and then the two other guards are filling in with, I believe, double figures. So there's three guys on the court at all times that are a major threat for us. And their coach usually has them playing pretty physical defense, and at times some of the teams we've lost to have been very physical, so we talked about responding to that this game. Don't get knocked off your spot and, you know, run the play with force, and we should be fine.
Well, Coach, along those same lines, what do you feel one or two of the biggest deciding factors for tonight are going to be?
From what we've seen on film, we're going to have to mix and match defense. I mean, too much man, it seems like they get comfortable and they score. Too much zone, they kind of get comfortable and score. So we're going to try and switch up our stuff as much as possible, and hopefully that keeps them off kilter enough and create those turnovers with those situations, and then we can get into that secondary and score the ball the way we like to.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck for tonight's game.
All right, thank you.
Bishop Garrigan boys basketball coach Mark Meister here on Home Country Radio KLGZ. We'll step aside for a quick timeout and come back for more next on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle, passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Phil's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Amari Thomas, sophomore, number 33.
Schwab's mid-range jumper's no good. Thomas got the rebound, puts it back up, and puts it in.
Drew Muller, junior, number 23.
Outside Muller, he'll step back. Three on the way, and he sticks it.
Justin Bauer, senior, number 15.
Rises for a mid-range jumper, rolls off no good. The follow by Bauer, he put it in, he got fouled. Chance for a three-point play by Justin Bauer.
Carter Schwab, sophomore, number 24.
1.2 seconds left. Schwab from three quarters court. Oh, and he put it in! Carter Schwab knocks down the three right before halftime.
Michael Joyce, freshman number 11.
And the inbounds play is going nowhere. Joyce picks it up to the backcourt, and he's going to flush it! Michael Joyce with the first throwdown of his high school career. Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Getting ready for high school basketball action on Home Country Radio KLGZ as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears against the St. Edmund Gales. For St. Edmund under head coach Adolph Kokendorfer, they will have the 6'2" senior Sam Miracle, the 6'1" sophomore Jacob Koopman, the 6' sophomore Jack McElroy, the 6'2" senior JT Loffersweiler, the 6'4" sophomore Hunter Horn, and check that Koopman is out tonight. It is the 6' sophomore Grant Gallus in his place for the St. Edmund Gales. Gales come in at 3-3 on the season. They'll face the 5-4 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Golden Bears in the home white uniform tonight. Gold numbering on the front and back. The gold Garrigan across the front. St. Edmund in the road to greens. The white lettering and numbering on the front. The Gales cross the chest of the jersey. At midcourt, the 6'4" sophomore Hunter Horn. Fort Dodge transfer going up against the 6'3" sophomore Amari Thomas for Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears and Gales getting set to go here tonight. Thomas and Horn at midcourt. Ball's in there. Horn wins the tap, and we are underway from Bishop Garrigan High School. Miracle collects the ball, and St. Edmund will head from right to left on the radio dial. St. Edmund so far this season scoring 59.2 points per game. They have the rock as McElroy has it far side of the court. McElroy drives in, pump fakes, deals near side. Horn beyond the perimeter. Horn in the lane, floats it up off the front of the rim, and Thomas grabs his first rebound. Racing the other way, Michael Joyce. Find Schwab, top of the key. Three-point ball in rhythm. Clangs off to the right, no good. Rebound popped up in the air twice. It's collected near the on the near side of the court by Gallus initially, and it's shoveled out and taken by Miracle for St. Edmund. Then thrown away immediately. Here comes Schwab for Bishop Garrigan. Schwab driving in. Schwab with the window, no good. And Horn skies in for the rebound. This game is going to be played in the paint tonight. Not of these teams much of a three-point taking team. St. Edmund taking under 14 threes per game. Bishop Garrigan just over 14 threes attempted per game as Bauer jumps a pass, knocks it away into the backcourt. Out of bounds as it will stay with St. Edmund.
That's the second pass knocked away by the Bears. Definitely turned up some pressure defensively. Schwab and Bauer both putting pressure at midcourt, going for that steal.
St. Edmund has the sophomore McElroy for the rock right now, averaging 7.8 points per game. McElroy on the drive. The floater's up, and it's good. St. Edmund throws the first punch up 2-0. On the other end, pass is jumped. Gallus takes it. Gallus runs the floor. Mahler will back off. Gallus lays it up and in. 4-0 St. Edmund. Schwab handles the rock for Bishop Garrigan. Averaging 13.3 points per game, finds Joyce on the left wing. Joyce guarding in, cut off by McElroy. Out to Schwab, left angle three-pointer, and Schwab finds the bottom of the net.
Well, after missing his first two attempts of the day, Schwab, no fear, taking that open three-pointer. First one missed badly, that one swishes right through.
St. Edmund 4, Bishop Garrigan 3, 6:24 on the clock, quarter number one. Gallus works the baseline, pump fakes, puts it up and puts it in. He slid by Thomas and Bauer to make it 6-3.
He's definitely not the biggest guy on the floor, but he's not afraid to go inside strong.
Gallus normally off the bench, starting for Koopman tonight as Bauer tried the backdoor cut. Thomas didn't realize he was going to cut and threw behind him out of bounds for a turnover.
Garrigan loves that backdoor cut. Anytime that guard feels their defense overplaying, they make that backdoor. Scored a lot of points on these backdoor plays over the years. St. Ed's with the three-point lead is going to slow her down a little bit.
St. Edmund has the ball right now, another floater. No good. Thomas tips the rebound and keeps it alive and gets it into Mahler as St. Edmund goes one and done. Schwab sidearm pass up ahead to Joyce. Joyce drives the baseline. Joyce shot blocked out of bounds. Horn of the rim protection for St. Edmund.
Yeah, nice block. Two young men really elevated there. Joyce way off the ground. The opponent really had to get up there to block that shot. Nicely done.
Schwab finds Mahler in the left corner. Rotates it around to Bauer on the wing. Bishop Garrigan scoring just under 65 points per game so far this season. St. Edmund letting up 54.5 as Joyce passes into Lane. Knocked away. Maracle got a hand on it. And here comes St. Edmund into the front court with Loffersweiler. Loffersweiler, QB1 in football, slices in. Pump fakes, puts it up. Shot no good as Schwab stayed vertical. Thomas rebound and a foul on St. Edmund.
Foul call there will break the pace a little bit. 5:35 left in this first quarter. Both teams really running the floor well. Some heavy shoulders breathing out there.
The foul will go against JT Loffersweiler, the 6'2" senior, one of two seniors in the St. Edmund starting lineup. Schwab up top, passes left to Joyce. Joyce looks inside, then goes back up top to Schwab with 5:24 on the clock. Schwab another three, pops out, no good. Thomas off the board. Thomas follow, and he draws the foul. Amari Thomas into the starting lineup tonight in place of Logan Nemers, and he will shoot two free throws.
Boy, Amari just slid in there. The Gales thought they had an easy rebound there, but Amari Thomas keeping the ball alive, slides his body underneath the basket, reaches up with his long wingspan, keeps it alive. See, he's wearing a big old tape job on his thumb there, Tyler. Must have sprained his thumb at practice.
Thomas sets up for the free throw, and he knocks it down. Well, in spite of the bandage on his wrist, Thomas had a great game against North Iowa on Tuesday. Double-double of 10 points and 10 rebounds. Bishop Garrigan got a lot of interior scoring during that game as Thomas tees up the second free throw. In and out, no good. Ball popped loose. Thomas trying to track it down, almost shoveled it back into play. Look out, student section. Thomas was coming in at full speed and avoided a collision in the front row.
Oh, yeah, Amari Thomas, he's going for it. Missed the free throw, almost gets his own rebound. Michael Joyce kept it alive with an athletic play there. Here come the Gales.
There's nearly Amari Thomas going headfirst into Sam Platt in the student section. I like Amari in that matchup, Beanie. I don't know about you.
I think so, too. Sam is a tough kid, but Amari's got the size.
St. Edmund with the basketball right now. It's Miracle. Miracle spins right. Thomas stays in front. Miracle bangs it off the glass. No good. Had a decent look, but Thomas vacuums in the rebound. Schwab across the timeline for Bishop Garrigan. Weaves left and finds Michael Joyce. The Golden Bear freshman drives in, stops the dribble, and gets it back outside the perimeter to Schwab. Whips the ball right to Bauer. 4:45 on the clock. Now back to Schwab. Shadowed by Loffersweiler. Schwab drives right. Dumps it off to Thomas. Thomas off the window, and he puts it in again. We are tied at 6.
Beautiful pass by Schwab. Drives hard to the basket. Amari Thomas was the only one who knew that the ball was coming his way. Nice pass by Schwab.
And Loffersweiler made a concerted effort to force Schwab to his right side that time, but resulted in a great pass. In the lane, Loffersweiler, nice dump off underneath, and laying it up and in is Andrew Clavey, who just came off the St. Edmund bench. There's two to make it 8-6. Bauer leaking out down the court. Baseline jumper left short. Thomas offensive board. Knocked away from him, though, by Clavey. Out of bounds, and Thomas touched it last.
Oh, right back at you. Both guards showing that they can drive the paint and then dump it off at the very end to an open shooter. Good point guards battling today.
St. Edmund coming off a 58-54 loss against Iowa Falls Alden on Tuesday. They are missing Jacob Koopman, one of their starters, as well as their top bench player, Andrew Clavey. Loffersweiler jumper from the paint, and he knocks it down. 10-6 St. Edmund. Or check that, 8-8. Nope, 10-6 St. Edmund. I was right. They put the wrong score on the scoreboard there initially. Gales up 10-6. Bauer in the left corner finds Mahler in the paint. Stripped away. Ball will roll along the baseline. And last touch by St. Edmund as Loffersweiler had the deflection that time.
Now, Loffersweiler, the quarterback for the Gales, carried the ball a lot for them, Tyler. Lots of speed on Loffersweiler. He really got up the floor well there. And he takes it to the hoop. Normally, St. Ed's teams are very methodical on offense. I've seen Coach Adolf Kokendorfer for many years now. This team, not wasting any time offensively.
Logan Nemers comes in for Drew Mahler for Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears have the two bigs right now as Schwab drives in, finds Thomas among a ton of green jerseys. Ball gets tipped right back to Thomas, and it's knocked away. Here comes St. Edmund. It's Gallus on the run out. Gallus gets cut off by three white jerseys. Kicks it out for a three-point ball. Left short by Miracle, and Nemers has his first rebound. Quickly to Joyce. Joyce on the run. Joyce slicing into the lane. Joyce floats it up, and he floats it in.
Oh, credit Logan Nemers on a great outlet pass. Got the rebound, kept it up above his head, flipped it out to Joyce, who did the rest. Lightning quick down the floor, 2 points.
Golden Bears defeated St. Edmund last year 76-40. Bishop Garrigan has beaten St. Edmund 6 of the last 7 matchups between these teams. As the Gales have the rock right now as we take down to the 3-minute mark in quarter number 1, 10-8 St. Edmund. Miracle kicks it out to the right wing. McElroy, bounce pass back out to Miracle. Head fakes, jumps, passes to the baseline, but it's intercepted by Thomas. Thomas cut off Gallus that time as Joyce runs the floor, sidesteps, puts it in, draws the foul. Chance for a 3-point play by Michael Joyce.
Well, he'll go for a 3. Everyone pause to make sure that basket was good. Good defensive play there, but Joyce better offensively. Boy, Tyler, Michael Joyce really knows how to go downhill with that ball. He gets the outlet pass, and he is just heading straight for the hoop. Does a nice little setup dribble crossover to get to the basket, but Boy, he really attacks that basket heading downhill.
Joyce no good on the free throw, and we have a lane violation called, so Joyce is going to get a mulligan here. And he is a downhill player, 100% for the Golden Bears. Of course, he can pull for three, but he's been great off the drive. Had a few three-point plays against North Union this past Friday. The free throw in and out, rebound in the paint by Clavey for St. Edmund. Clavey averaging 6 points per game off the bench for the Gales. Loffersweiler has it right now, guarded by Trayton Sink, who just checked in. Up top, with the ball, it's Gallus, being pestered by a couple Golden Bear defenders. Bishop Garrigan going to try to mix between man and zone tonight as Loffersweiler's short quarter jumper left short. It gets away from Thomas. Loffersweiler saves it into play, but his foot was on the baseline and out of bounds.
A couple good saves so far in this game. A minute ago, Schwab saved one right to Thomas. That time, Loffersweiler, not only is he flying out of bounds midair, he notes where his teammates are. He doesn't just chuck it wildly.
Schwab guns it up to Sink on the right wing, finding Nemers posting up inside. Nemers off the glass, and there's two.
Great touch by Logan Nemers, wearing a big knee brace on his right knee today. Three Bears wearing braces out there.
12-10, Bishop Garrigan. Down in the right corner, St. Edmund has the basketball, getting swarmed as McElroy. McElroy pestered by Joyce and Thomas. He dribbles away from it. He floats it in.
Nice touch. Just floats up. Oh, here comes Joyce.
Joyce the other way. St. Edmund with a couple good floaters so far early in this game as Joyce floats his own shot up. That one a little bit too strong. Sink tries to tap it out, but it's right into the hands of Loffersweiler with 1:50 left in the quarter. Loffersweiler guns it into the right corner to Miracle. Back outside as they find McElroy. 1:42 left in the first, 12-12 tie. Loffersweiler far side of the court. Picks up his dribble on the wing, turns his back to the bucket and skids the pass into the corner to McElroy. Rises for three, left it short, chases down his own miss. Sink pokes it away briefly, but McElroy has it with a fresh 35 on the clock.
Oh, McElroy with the hustle, following his own shot, classic fundamental.
Far side, it's Loffersweiler. Soft jab step and gets it back up top to Miracle. Miracle, a 6'2" senior, gets it into the corner to Clavey. Clavey jumper, long two, and it's short. Off of the board, though, and the putback is up and good. Oh, putting it in is Gallus.
Gallus was Johnny on the spot. He was right in the middle of three Bears, and it came right into his mitts. Coach Meister's going to call a timeout and challenge his players. He knows that can't happen. I think he also wants to see a little better ball control. Bears are prone to little turnovers here in the first quarter. Close game, though, Tyler.
14-12 in favor of St. Edmund right now. And it's interesting watching the Gales offense execute, Beatty, because, you know, you said how methodical they normally are. You know, they're going a little bit at a faster pace this year, but I do find it interesting to see all the different spots they're shooting from. We've seen that short corner jumper already. We've seen a couple of three-point balls. We've seen the floater from the lane. They obviously have a pretty wide arsenal of different shots they can try to go to against a Golden Bear team that has shown a little zone here in the first.
Yeah, and so far they've shown their ability to really set up their shots well. They do a lot of good ball fakes, draw the defense off, and create open shots when they can't get one. But yeah, Tyler, over the years, St. Ed's always very dynamite at executing offense and taking care of that basketball.
14-12, St. Edmund. Nick Lear in for Amari Thomas, Richard Garrigan. Nemers tries to wrap the pass around to Lear, but it's out of his reach and out of bounds for a turnover.
Oh, that was a great setup by the Bears coming out of the timeout. Had a nice play there. Nemers gets it on the block. Lear's on the opposite block. The wraparound pass just went a little wide. Unfortunate.
St. Edmund has the basketball right now. Pass down towards the baseline, tipped away by Nemers as he keeps his feet in bounds and finds Schwab. Schwab will get it up ahead with 48 seconds left in the quarter. Tries to fire it into Lear, but the pass intercepted by Clavey. Clavey sprints the other way, gets by Nemers, threads the pass into the lane, finds the cutting Gallus, who lays it in.
Wow, what a pass. Clavey somehow got that pass. Trayton Sink, who was in really good position there, went right through him.
16-12, St. Edmund. Schwab almost traveled up top as he got it off to Sink. Sink looking for Lear, posting up inside, into the center of the paint, shoots it through contact and draws the foul. Spun into two green jerseys that time and got hit on the arm. Is that his foul number four against St. Edmund, and two free throws coming by Lear.
Yeah, Lear likes to elevate there. He's very tall. He elevates. He can really get up and twist in midair and kind of contorts his body to get that up to the basket.
Lear 4-14 at the foul line so far this season. Coming off a really good game against North Iowa is the first free throw, no good. 14 points and 6 boards off the bench on Tuesday against the Bison, and that 72-46 win as Tate Furch and Justin Bauer replace Carter Schwab and Michael Joyce.
Yeah, Coach Meister, you know, he's got about 9 deep he'll go. Everyone's getting playing time and chances out there. Tate Furch, first time into the game here. Bauer comes back after starting.
Second free throw good by Lear. St. Edmund 16, Bishop Garrigan 13. Shot clock is off as the Gales have the rock right now. Ty Miracle, the freshman who just checked in, handling it against Sink. Passes left to Sam Miracle. Rotates in the corner to Gallus. Now back to Sam Miracle of 10 seconds. Sam Merkel, the senior averaging 13.2 points per game, gives it off to Loffersweiler, 5 seconds. Loffersweiler trying to create a floater, partially blocked. Nemers gets the rebound, gets it out to Sink. Sink half-court heave at the horn, off the shot clock, no good. And that will bring an end to quarter number one. St. Edmund 16, Bishop Garrigan 13 as you head to the second on KLGZ 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial.
certainly don't lose. Drew Muller and Amari Thomas come out, but 2 6-footers come back in. So, yeah, Tyler, you said early on, this game might be played in the paint here. Garrigan utilizing their size. Clavey's going to come out and get a pointer on his three-point shooting, that one that missed badly. He just took too much time. Sometimes, Tyler, you get too much time to shoot, and you think about it too much, and you miss badly.
4:48 on the clock, 22-21. Sorry, folks, our audio went down here, but we just found out about that as we got it back. Now Joyce up the floor. Joyce slicing in. Joyce off the window, and he scores it again. 24-21.
He's gaining momentum, and Coach Kochendorfer knows that. Calls timeout and says, listen, we can't let Michael Joyce just get started. We got to kill that momentum as he is just turning on the heat.
30-second timeout called by St. Edmund. Their first timeout taken in the ball game is Joyce with 11, and Bishop Garrigan with a 24-21 lead so far in this ball game. Good effort on the glass. We're seeing both these teams crash the glass pretty hard so far. They've got some good length inside, some second chance opportunities for both teams early on in this ball game. As it's 24-21, Bishop Garrigan. But Golden Bears with their final game before winter break, as it is for St. Edmund as well. Gales dealing with a lot of sickness on their team. They had a game canceled this past Friday against Clear Lake, as they just did not have enough healthy players. And even this past Tuesday against Iowa Falls, Alden played but did not have their full roster healthy.
Well, it is going around everywhere, I guess, because we've had some illnesses at Garrigan as well. Let's all disinfect that basketball after this basketball game is played.
Yes, 100%. As we have 4.5 minutes left in the first half, St. Edmund with the basketball. Pass goes left to Miracle. Miracle down to the baseline to Wafersweiler. Gets it to Horn. Horn off the fingertips, puts it in.
Well, nice setup on that play. Good passing by the Gales. Drew the defense over, made the extra pass inside.
24-23 in favor of Bishop Garrigan right now. Lear in the high post, gets it down to Nemers. Nemers off the window, and there's two.
Boy, I just don't see any answer that the Gales have for Nemers inside.
4 minutes left in the second quarter. St. Edmund has Wafersweiler dribbling between a double team. Gets it into the lane. His pass intercepted. He was trying to find Miracle as Schwab takes it. Quickly gets it out to Joyce. Joyce behind everyone. Layup too strong at the glass. Lear tip no good. And Horn picks the rebound out of the air. Horn gets it up ahead. St. Edmund does not have numbers as Horn waits for his teammates to catch up. Back in the corner to Horn. Drives baseline. Floats over Nemers. Left the floater short. Tipped rebound and taken by Joyce. And up goes to Schwab as we're down to 3:33 in the quarter. 26-23 Garrigan. Schwab charging in, and that is going to be an offensive foul against Schwab.
Oh, yep. Schwab was trying to get it going, too. He's trying to get his offensive game going. He just made a great steal a moment ago playing center field. He kind of sets up. He knows where they're passing it. He makes the steal, wanted to turn it into two. But defense to offense didn't go so well. Just his first foul on Schwab. Here come the Gales with Wafersweiler.
3:29 on the clock. St. Edmund has the basketball right now as McElroy brings it across half court. McElroy averaging 3.8 assists per game, gets it to Miracle. Now back up near half court to McElroy. His sink creeps out to defend. McElroy left of the paint, trying to keep that back foot, and he traveled.
Yep, drug that pivot foot. Boy, you can see the Gales now really trying to set up set plays. That's what caused that travel. Here comes Joyce. No one's watching.
And Joyce trying to sneak past and see if he can get an easy bucket out of that, but St. Edmund got their heads around quickly enough to stop that as Joyce underhands it out to Sink. Now right side to Schwab. They're trying to force Schwab right again as the pass goes to Joyce. In front of the Gale bench, Nemers in the post. Nemers powers it up. He put it in, and the foul.
Oh, yeah, the big man with the power dribble. Horn has to give ground there, and he tries to maintain his vertical position, but he's going to get called for the push. Those are the frustrating ones, Tyler, when you're playing against someone that's bigger than you. You look over at your coach and say, what am I supposed to do? I'm straight up and down. I'm trying to hold my ground, but I can't stop this big man from getting closer to the rim.
Nemers' free throw is good, and Bishop Garrigan leads 29-23. Nemers, a 62.5% free throw shooter this year, takes advantage of that opportunity, and we're down to 2:50 left before halftime. Horn bounce pass outside to Miracle. Miracle picks up his dribble and bounces it left to McElroy. McElroy gets it back over to the right to Wafersweiler, drives in, finds Horn at the foul line. Horn in the paint, hooks the shot up to the right hand and drops in at a soft touch.
Yeah, soft touch is right. He really just floats that thing up there. Nice touch by the 6'4 transfer.
2:25 left in the second quarter, 29-25 Bishop Garrigan. Joyce kicks it out to Schwab. Schwab heads towards the foul line, now back onto the wing to Joyce. Joyce directs traffic with the right hand. He'll dribble right around the perimeter and stop at the top of the key. Back to the left wing to Schwab. 14 on the shot clock for Garrigan. Right back to Joyce. Joyce looking. Joyce wants to drive. Flips it into Nemers. Nemers in a crowd. Shot no good. And a rebound by Horn.
Good set play by Garrigan. They really were working that, looking for that play to Nemers. They get it, but just off the mark.
Bounce pass to Horn. Horn burying the shoulder against Nemers. Gets it back into the corner to McElroy. Up top to Loffersweiler. Loffersweiler in the paint. Shot off the glass. No good. Long rebound tips out. It finds McElroy. McElroy jumper rolls off. And Nemers secures the rebound.
Nemers playing real hard right now.
Quickly looks for one of the Bishop Garrigan guards. Finds Joyce. Joyce hits a spin move. Blows a tire. But a blocking foul against St. Edmund. Foul number three against the Gales. And Coach Kokendorfer not going to be happy with that call.
Yeah, definitely not happy with the official there. Bears were driving downhill. Michael Joyce did the spin move, lost his footing, hit the deck. And the blocking foul was called. And Coach Kokendorfer says, you can't bail him out with that one. At least give us a travel or how about a no call. But once that whistle blows, Tyler, they don't go in reverse.
They do not. As Bishop Garrigan will have it underneath the basket. Schwab down towards the right side. As the Golden Bears lead 29-25, both teams with three fouls in the second quarter. Lear trying to scrap and get possession, catches the inbounds pass. Lear shot off the back of the cup, no good. And the rebound is secured by Clavey for St. Edmund. Clavey into the front court, averaging 6 points per game off the bench for St. Edmund, and has 1:25 on the clock. Garrigan daring him to shoot it. Bounce pass to the cutting Gallus. It's off his foot. Nemers dies on top of Gallus.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man, and he may be hurt. Garrigan has the basketball. Gallus is still down. Schwab into the front court. And they're going to blow the buzzer here and take care of the injured player. Boy, both players are just going for the loose ball, but Nemers landed right on top of Gallus that time, and he is down on the floor right now for St. Edmund.
Yeah, two guys fighting for the loose ball off the rebound, and they both hit the deck. And Gallus's hand was trapped underneath his own body, but he had Nemers' weight on top of him. And so he had the weight of two players all pushing on that hand, and I think he probably at least sprained a finger. They're going to sub in and call someone in. And, yeah, his right arm hurting there. He's going to walk off on his own power, of course. Tough kid. But, he dinged up his wrist, hand something.
Elias Colossia will check into the ball game for St. Edmund, the 6'3" junior, as we will wait and see how Gallus does. But he will head back to the Gale bench with 1:16 on the clock and a 29-25 advantage. Again. A quick pace of action so far in this one. And as expected, a lot of driving, a lot of ball into the paint, and a lot of traffic in that painted area as well tonight. But
well, Tyler, like you said, neither team really was looking to take that three-point shot. Garrigan realizes they have an advantage with Nemers and Lear inside right now, but even when they're out, Muller and Amari Thomas have the size advantage. And the Gales have passed up numerous three-point shots. Don't feel comfortable taking that shot, or they don't want to. And unfortunately for the Gales, Gallus has been one of their main scorers. Every time they need a bucket, Gallus has been able to come through and get one. But he's going to be on the bench with this dinged up wing for the time being. A minute and 16 left to go till half, and then I think they'll get a better look at this guy. But the trainer for St. Ed's was here, it appears, and is giving him the look over right now.
St. Edmund shoots from the mid-range, probably more than any team Garrigan has seen so far this season. A lot of teams have shied away from that now, but St. Edmund certainly has not. As we're down to 1:15 left in the first half, as Bishop Garrigan leads by four. 29-25, sink on the left wing. And offensive foul. They're going to get Lear trying to get position inside against Colossio, just checking into the ball game for Garrigan's fourth.
Colossio, the junior, comes in. He's a solid player coming off the bench. He's a scoring threat as well. So St. Ed showing a little bit of depth. Impressive after they're coming off of illness.
McElroy into the front court, passes it over to the right side. Ty Miracle, the freshman, now back up top to McElroy. Guarded by Sink. Garrigan sits back in a zone defense once again as Loffersweiler has it on the right wing with 54 seconds left in the first half. Left side, McElroy. McElroy dribbles with the right hand and heads a couple steps toward the right. Gives it off to Loffersweiler, 13 on the shot clock. Loffersweiler into the lane, rises for a jumper, left it short, and Nemers picks the rebound out of the air. Schwab threads the pass up to Joyce, behind everyone. Joyce finger rolls it in.
Wow, what a pass. Full court bounce pass from Schwab to Joyce. Impressive.
13 points by Joyce and a blocking foul on Trayton Sink. That'll be Bishop Garrigan's fifth foul. This will send St. Edmund to the free throw line with 30 seconds left in the half.
You know, I will say Schwab has not got his shooting going so far today. with 3 points thus far. But he is really, every time he gets that ball, he is looking to get that ball up the floor on that fast break. Sometimes he gets it, sometimes he doesn't, holds up. But that time, boy, Joyce was sprinting the floor, and Schwab just throws a bullet.
Here's McElroy, who's 2 of 7 at the foul line so far this season. And the first one rattles off no good, and we stay at 31-25. St. Edmund is a team this year just a shade over 59%, 59.1% from the charity stripe.
Well, Tyler, you haven't said the words Joyce and Crooks for a season, but they just entered the gym to much acclaim over there at stage left. That's fun to see those kids back from college playing their college basketball at the women's college basketball level.
Yeah, a lot of former Garrigan athletes back in the house tonight to be honored at halftime as Schwab has it with 17 seconds left in the quarter. Shot clock is off. And now 13 seconds as Joyce has it down to our right. Back up to the top of the key to Schwab. 9 seconds, rotates it to Sink. Hits it in the post to Nemers. Quickly back out to Schwab. Catches, fires, drills a three-pointer. 2 seconds left in the first half. St. Edmund's gonna have to hustle here. Colossi, a three-quarter court heave, will be off to the right, no good. And Bishop Garrigan goes up 34-26 right before halftime. We'll step aside for a timeout. Get back to halftime after this on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, 2 sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game. High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass, for all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realty, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock. Sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce. Two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services. View their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic. Animals large and small. They love them all.
Style Salon. Your salon in Algona. Create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
Halftime from Bishop Garrigan High School as the Golden Bears lead the St. Edmund Gales by a score of 34-26. Carter Schwab knocked down a three-pointer right before halftime, just as he did earlier this season, Beanie. That's becoming a habit for Carter Schwab, and that gave Bishop Garrigan a little bit of breathing room, but an entertaining first half, back and forth. Both teams really looking to get the ball inside, looking to attack, and crashing the glass hard. That's created a really physical, grinded-out type of game so far in this Golden Bear gym.
Yeah, it sure has. You know, Tyler, you get the feeling watching Carter Schwab. He spent so much time in a gym, his dad being the girls' coach. Growing up, that kid grows up in a gym. You have a feeling that he does a lot of scenarios in his head where he's got a countdown going in his head. 5, 4, 3. Because he looks more comfortable in those scenarios sometimes than he does in the middle of the game. But he was pretty cold. He hit a three-pointer earlier in the game after missing a couple shots. Had a little trouble getting his point guard shots going, but he's distributing the ball well. And that three-pointer before half was kind of a crusher for St. Ed's because, you know, the lead was minimal, but now 8 points in the game like this is pretty solid lead against a team like St. Ed's that doesn't seem to want to shoot the three-point ball where they could come back in the game really quickly. They're going to have to get defensive stops and turn it in. But they've had some nice offense on their own, some good mid-range jump shots.
So 34-26 at the half is right now. We're going to welcome Bishop Garrigan girls basketball coach Brandon Schwab onto the halftime show here. Coach, obviously no game for you guys tonight, so you kind of get to sit back and relax and watch the girls game. But I guess just how's the start of winter break going for your team going into the break?
Well, going good. We had our annual 6-on-6 game today in practice, so we did our revisited 6-on-6 girls basketball in Iowa in practice today. We had three teams going of 6-on-6 and kept score and had a good competition there, and then did our Secret Santa stuff with the kids, and then got a good lift in, and we're about to take some days off.
Well, Coach, it's always nice to go into winter break with a win, and that's what your team did as you guys beat North Iowa 71-41 on Tuesday to go into break at 9-1. You know, overall on Tuesday, what were a couple of your big takeaways from that game?
Well, you know, I didn't think we were that sharp Tuesday defensively or offensively. I think we kind of just went with the flow and went into Christmas break. You know, we had a tough week the week before with playing some good teams, and, you know, we weren't crisp on Tuesday. But, you know, we're going to have a few of them games, and I thought for the most part, you know, we shared the ball pretty well. We didn't defend as well as we're capable of. We were trying a couple different defenses we've been working on in the second half that we obviously need more work on. So before we put it into a close game, so we'll be working on some stuff over Christmas break and, you know, try to develop a little more balance in our defense.
And, Coach, obviously, like you said, the team's going to get a couple days off here to get the legs back under them and get back into practice. But, you know, from a Coach Schwab standpoint, as you kind of have a first half to look back on and some games to look ahead to in the second half, what does a Coach Schwab winter break look like?
Well, you know, we've obviously got to continue to get ourselves better on the offensive end and defensive end. You know, we've got we can play such good basketball at the right times. It's finding that consistency with the basketball. You know, and you know, just still trying to build some depth on this team. I thought. You know, the other night, Alyssa Hoglund really came in, and Reese Kemna came in and played some nice minutes for us and really got going. Alyssa with 12 points the other night. So just trying to build a little more depth on this team is my goal during Christmas break, of having a little more trust early in the game in our depth. And, you know, I see it getting better, and I just need to trust it as a coach and throw them in the fire a little more, you know, which isn't always an easy thing to do with young sophomores without a lot of varsity experience. But, you know, I mean, it's I'm excited over break to take a few days off here and shut the brain down of basketball and not worry about scouting a team or anything, and just kind of enjoying some family time and enjoying some a time away from the basketball a little bit.
Well, Coach, wrapping up here, obviously a lot of the winter break is going to be focusing on your own team and focusing on the improvements that you can make. But, of course, guys like me like to look ahead, and we see Forest City on the schedule coming out of winter break. When does the focus start turning to, all right, we've got to look at Forest City a little bit and start to see what we can do in that matchup?
You know, we'll probably start on Forest City probably Saturday of next week, you know, that we'll actually start talking about them in practice. We haven't touched any of that, and you know, and we, the first couple days getting back, we need to worry about us. But, you know, I'd say Saturday we start getting into that big matchup. You know, obviously they're a top 10 ranked 3A team, and you know, we're a top 10 ranked 1A team, and both undefeated in the conference, and us going on the road right out of break is we're going to have to be ready to play good basketball, because Four City's got a tremendous basketball team, and they're playing very good basketball, and well, we hope to be playing good then also. So you know, it's just we'll start Saturday, but mostly over break we're going to worry about ourselves, try to worry about getting ourselves a little better, and however it flies on January 2nd it flies. But I like what I've seen out of our team. Our team competes very hard. Our team shares the ball, and our team really can defend at a high level. So I like what we see, and I challenged them tonight of, let's be better even out after break. You know, let's clean some things up, and let's really get after it in the second half of the season.
Well, Coach, enjoy your winter break and enjoy the Christmas season. Thank you for stopping by.
All right, thank you. Merry Christmas.
That is Bishop Garrigan girls basketball coach Brandon Schwamp here on KLGZ Home Country Radio. Right now, a quick timeout, and we'll get ready for the second half next on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and the Elgato Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Elgato, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Phil's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Elgato, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toe.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance agent in Elgato. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
As we come back, Bishop Garrigan 34, St. Edmund 26, beginning the third quarter. Golden Bears had a 21-10 scoring advantage during that second period. Beanie, the biggest key to the second half for Bishop Garrigan.
Well, they have definitely got to take care of the basketball. They've got an 8-point lead, ball control. Got to be a premium this whole half against a tough Gale defense.
Well, Bishop Garrigan will have the basketball to start off the second half. Joyce on the right wing, wings it across to Schwab on the left wing. Now top of the key to Bauer. Bishop Garrigan 34, St. Edmund 28. Gales had a 16-13 lead after one as Joyce has it top of the key right now. Joyce left of the paint. Jumper fading back. Off the cup, no good. Tipped out of bounds and last touched by St. Edmund as it will stay for the Golden Bears.
Yeah, referee right there. That was a tough one to see because both Amari Thomas and Laffiswiler, I'm sorry, Horn for St. Ed's, both elevated. Both seemed to hit it at the same time.
Schwab from the baseline. Gets it into Thomas, edge of the paint. Back to the bucket, hands it off to Schwab on the elbow. Schwab spins towards the right. Schwab rises up and he puts it in. 10-point lead, the largest for Garrigan tonight.
A strong move to the basket for Schwab, who then he jumps the pass just like a D-back.
Out of bounds off of St. Edmund.
Wow.
That was last touched by McElroy. That's a great defensive play by Schwab.
Yeah, it was. He just scores. He hustles back on defense, just like a defensive back. He goes over and tries to intercept the pass. And then during the fumble ruski that happening, it went off a St. Ed's player. But Coach Kokendorfer is arguing with the officials right now, saying there's no way. And they're just in discussions right now, but they're not going to reverse this call, and Michael Joyce will inbound it to Justin Bauer. And here comes Joyce up the floor.
Joyce to the rock for Garrigan. Gets it off to Bauer, rotates it over to Schwab. Thomas trying to get position inside. He'll screen and try to get Mahler open. Bauer, or make that Schwab wants to drive, gets it out to Mahler. Right wing three-pointer, and Mahler knocks it down.
Oh, nice shot by Mahler. Gets a high five from Schwab as they go down, but the Gales quick on the attack. Here comes Horn.
Laffiswiler rotates it into the corner to Miracle. Right back to Laffiswiler as Bauer blankets him on the perimeter. Laffiswiler pumps inside and gets it back out top to McElroy. McElroy, the 6-foot sophomore, heads right around the perimeter. Joyce in front of him. With 6:52 in the clock, McElroy enters the lane, shoots a jumper over Thomas, and he banks it in as it spun around and popped back through.
Well, another mid-range drive and pull-up jump shot by the Gales, really specializing on that in their offense.
Justin Bauer off the rock right now, 6:37 on the clock, finds Thomas inside, he juggles it, and it's taken away by St. Edmund. Laffiswiler across half court, Laffiswiler stops in the middle of the paint, and gets it out to the top of the key to Miracle. Miracle takes a step towards the right. Bauer stays in front again. Miracle in trouble, has to get rid of it before the 5-second call comes in as he finds Laffiswiler. Laffiswiler looking towards the right corner as he gets it down there to McElroy. McElroy works the baseline. McElroy too deep to shoot it. Gets it out to the wing. Gallus tees up a three-point ball, and Gallus swishes it.
Well, that's good news for the Gales. Gallus was the player who went down hard with Logan Nemers in the second quarter and looked like he had a pretty severe injury to his arm, but he's right back in there nailing the three.
Mahler in the paint. Turnaround, no good. Thomas gets the rebound, and Thomas is fouled. There's a push by St. Edmund, their first foul of the quarter.
Just a wild rebound. I don't know if you can call a rebound wild, but no, now they're going to say Amari, when he got that rebound, pushed. Boy, that was a wild rebound because Amari Thomas elevated so far off the ground and then came down over the top of a Gale, but in the act of the rebound, he certainly wasn't over the back, but coming down, he's going to call for foul, and that's three on Thomas, so he's going to have to take a seat.
First team foul of the quarter on Bishop Garrigan as Lear replaces Thomas. Jumper misses right. Ball is loose in the lane. Four players crash into the ground for it. We've got a jump ball. Everyone getting down there as Schwamp got tied up with McElroy. Possession arrow is towards St. Edmund.
That will stay down here. Garrigan will set up in a 2-3 defense that they're going to match up out of. Bauer at the top. He's been playing great defense, and he blankets Horn on the inbounds pass.
Horn has been quiet so far tonight for St. Edmund, and that is good news for Bishop Garrigan. Wiverswile was in trouble. He's in a corner double team, and then a foul. Oh, Lear fouled him, and that kind of bailed St. Edmund out because there was no room for Wiverswile to operate.
It did. I think that's what Michael Joyce is encouraging about right now. They had him dead to rights in a trap right in the corner of the gym, and Lear just went for a little extra hip right in front of the official, and the official saw it.
Gallus passing it into the corner to Miracle. Miracle driving, rising for a jumper, clangs off the glass, no good, and Schwab boxes out for the rebound.
Miracle couldn't shoot that over Lear, standing 6'6". Here's Schwab driving.
Schwab crossover dribble. Schwab takes the contact, but he traveled. Shot no good, wipe that off, and Schwab turns it over as Garrigan, make it St. Edmund, gets the ball back.
Well, reversal of fortune for Schwab. He was ready to go to the free throw line. Looked like an and one situation. He put the bucket in, but gets called for the little, must have been a little foot shuffle there.
5:15 on the clock, 39-31 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears led by as many as 13 in this quarter, but St. Edmund has scored the last five. Down to the baseline, Miracle pumps a couple times, puts it off the glass and scores.
Oh, that was nice, nice backdoor cut, nice pass. Here comes Joyce.
7-0 run by St. Edmund. They've gotten back into it. It's 39-33 as Garrigan looks to bring Logan Nemers into the game at the next stoppage. Bounce pass right side, Bauer. In the lane, Lear. Lear puts it up. Lear missed the layup, and it's picked off the air by Miracle.
Yeah, no doubt Nemers getting back in there, going to pull down some boards. That no one has the body size that Nemers has. They're going to get him back in.
Wiverswile losing the ball. He and Joyce go tumbling for it as it's knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Joyce.
You know, Justin Bauer and Michael Joyce putting a lot of pressure on the guards for the Gales up top. And been pretty successful at putting pressure on there as long as they can keep the Gales from driving for that mid-range jumper.
So a six-point game right now. St. Edmund continues their 7-0 run. Horn in between two players, bullets it off the hands of Wiverswile. It is out of bounds and back to Bishop Garrigan.
Turnovers are the theme of this third quarter. Neither team taking great care of the ball here.
About halfway through the third quarter, we're at the 4:30 mark right now as Schwab takes it across half court for the Golden Bears. Gets the rock over to Bauer. Nemers trying to post up inside as Horn fronts him. Ball rotates around the perimeter to Joyce on the left wing. Nemers gets on the other side of the block. Nemers fades back. Nemers knocks it down.
Oh, I was worried there. Nemers had the left-handed move, but he opted to go right. Still puts in the bucket.
41-33, Bishop Garrigan driving in Gallus, cut off by Nemers, flings it to the outside. Wiverswile with the basketball right now. Wiverswile looks, flips it onto the wing to Gallus, rotates it into the corner. Miracle catching fire free, and he splashes it in.
Not a lot of three-pointers shot. That was a big one. 41-36, they've cut it to five.
Miracle 5 points so far. He was St. Edmund's leading scorer last year at 17.6 points per game as a Schwab three-point ball misses towards the near side of the court, and then a foul in transition. That foul is going to go against Justin Bauer as he contacted McElroy for Bishop Garrigan's third foul.
Justin Bauer just goes for it there. You know, he thought he could maybe pick up a quick steal. Nothing hurt from that foul, just Bauer's first foul. Bears third of the quarter. Two more to go before they'll be shooting a two-shot foul. But a steal by Bauer here would be big. We need to get a run-out layup.
Driving into the lane, Gallus tries to find a cutting Miracle, but it's behind him and out of bounds. Right idea, but just a little off target there.
A second turnover in as many possessions for the Gales, and Coach Korpendorfer scratching the back of his neck saying, yeah, we can't do that, especially when we're down five. Schwab getting a breather, sink in the game. That'll put Joyce at the primary ball handler.
So Joyce will bring it across half court. McElroy guarding him. Joyce picks up his dribble and gives it off to Lear. Now to the right side to Sink. 3.5 minutes left in the third quarter as Bishop Garrigan leads 41-36. Bauer rainbows it into Nemers. Nemers tips it to himself and puts it in.
I'll tell you, Bauer is the guy that makes that pass inside, whether it's Thomas, Lear, or Nemers. Bauer looking to get the ball in there.
Bauer averaging 3.8 assists per game. Logan Nemers now with 11 points as Garrigan has two in double figures. Floater from just inside the foul line, no good by Miracle. Horn offensive rebound, turns to the right, put it in and draws the foul. 3-point play opportunity by Hunter Horn.
Well, I see these sweatshirts and t-shirts talking about all these high school kids always earning and never giving. Horn earned that one, Tyler, because he went up against Logan Nemers and Nick Lear, and he really fought that battle well. Somehow gets that rebound in the end, one situation. Nice job by Horn for St. Ed's.
Free throw no good. Off the hands of Nemers, though, and out of bounds as Nemers and Lear both went for it.
And both those guys are very sure-handed. Nemers had it. Nemers had it, and then just fumble Ruski.
Well, foul-wise, Bishop Garrigan has Lear a three and Thomas a three. Thomas sitting on the bench right now, Lear remaining in the game. 14 fouls by Garrigan in this quarter, so we're down to the three-minute mark of the third. St. Edmund could try to get in the bonus here as the drive into the lane, the jumper by McElroy, and he knocks it down. Finding his spot against that 2-3 zone, and it's a three-point game. Boy, moments ago, Garrigan was up 39-26, and right now it's 43-40, and Joyce, offensive foul.
Joyce is stunned. He's going to get called for putting that arm up, I think, and creating some separation. That's a big one. And that's the fifth foul on the Bears, but it's a player control foul, so there will need be no free throws on that. But then the next one, they will be shooting two shots. Bears switch up their defense. They're going man-to-man now.
And we have inadvertent horn. I think they're trying to get the shot clock fixed, and they will inbound of St. Edmund here. But this is a 14-4 run going on by the Gales since Garrigan took their largest lead of the game at 13 points.
Yeah, good adjustment by the Garrigan coaches. Get out of that 2-3 because the Gale guards were just driving hard to the middle of the 2-3 and pulling up for the jumpers.
2.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Gallus gives the ball off to Miracle. The St. Edmund senior stops the right elbow, guarded by Joyce, gets it back out top to Horn. Horn shadowed by Nemers. Joyce with the help defense as well. Ball sails out of bounds off the pass, and it's a turnover.
Yeah, just like that, change defenses. While the Gales are trying to figure out the new look, they turn it over. And boy, Tyler, like we said at halftime, ball control is a premium at this half. I'm surprised both these teams, we're right before Christmas break, I'm surprised as many turnovers are happening.
Garrigan will try to take care of the ball in this possession. Pass into Nemers, by himself, sets it in. Long rainbowing pass by Carter Schwab, and it's 13 points by Logan Nemers.
Great lob by Schwab. Can't stop Nemers inside when he gets it that deep.
Into the right corner, McElroy, left open for three. It pops out and then pops back in. 2-point game, McElroy knocks down a big three, and it's 45-43.
McElroy's second three since halftime. He's heating that up.
McElroy, the best three-point shooter in St. Edmund's starting lineup, as Lear gets inside, shot blocked. Nemers puts it up and puts it in off at the rebound.
What a touch by Nemers. Great block by the Gales on Lear's attempt, but Nemers right there keeps the ball up, tippy-toes it in.
15 points by Nemers. Down in the right corner, Loffersweiler being trapped. Joyce peels the ball away, and a travel by Loffersweiler.
Oh, Loffersweiler is not happy with that. And he pleads with his coaches, and they tell him, hey, just keep playing. Don't travel. But Joyce caused that, got a hand in there. Could have been a tie-up. That was one where the officials could have had three different calls.
Joyce brings it across the timeline, left side of the court as he hands it off to Sink. 1:22 left in the third quarter as Garrigan clings to a 4-point lead. Nemers high post, gets it outside to Mahler. Squares up for a free ball, rolls off the rim, no good. Ball is volleyball around, and Gallus takes the board. Up ahead, Loffersweiler on the wing, gets it into the right corner as he finds Clavey. Clavey back onto the wing to Loffersweiler. Top of the key, Gallus. Gallus starts to drive in, gets turned back outside by Sink with 1 minute left in the quarter. It's Clavey against Schwab. Clavey left of the paint. Clavey tough shot, and it wedges inside the rim of the backboard. No good. Here comes Schwab. Behind the back dribble, Schwab wings it over to the right to Joyce with 47 seconds left in the quarter. Now Schwab, top of the key, gets it back over to the right to Joyce. It's still 47-43 right now as Joyce gets to the foul line. Joyce prancing in. Joyce wide angle. Shot tipped. Horn got a finger on it, and St. Edmund has the ball.
They're going to choose if they want. They can use everything except 2 seconds before the bell.
Right side Horn. Horn drives past Nemers, floats over Schwab, rolls off no good. Ball near the boundary, saved in by St. Edmund, but they throw right to Joyce. Joyce into the front court, down the center of the paint, scoops the layup up. He put it in and the foul. Michael Joyce coast to coast with a chance for a three-point play.
Well, that is a turning point right there. It was a four-point game. St. Edmund's saves the ball. It looks like they're going to get a break, but they save it right into an area where Joyce runs it down, takes it the other way for an and-one situation. Tyler, we're going to look back at that game and say, well, we had a chance there until we threw it to them. Only 17 seconds left in the quarter. Huge turn of events. Joyce does hit the free throw, completes the three-point play. So that's a big swing in this game where it could have been advantage Gales if they use up that clock, score a bucket, and cut that lead to two. Now it's ballooned.
Joyce checks out, Furch checks in. As McElroy tries to get loose, Garrigan trying to finish the quarter strong as Clavey works the left baseline. 6 seconds on the game clock. He throws a pass that's picked by Nemers. Gets it off the sink with 3 seconds. Sink of two, sink of one. Sink floats it up. Got the shot off, but it rolls off no good. Furch tipped it in, but that is after the buzzer as the score will stay 50-43. 8 minutes of basketball action left before winter break as we'll step aside for a timeout and come back in the final 8 minutes on Home Country KLGZ.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game.
Fourth quarter from Bishop Garrigan High School as the Golden Bears lead the St. Edmund Gales 50-43 in this non-conference matchup. St. Edmund had a 17-16 scoring advantage in the third quarter. Golden Bears have the basketball to begin the fourth. Carter Swamp of 8 points so far tonight bounces the pass to Justin Bauer, and we're rolling in the fourth. Bauer being bodied up on defense, trying to shake away from Gallus, gets it off to Joyce. Joyce driving in, takes a blocking foul as that one goes against Jack McElroy, St. Edmund's first of the quarter.
Yep, fouls will reset. And St. Ed's is going to pick up some fouls here because they're going to ratchet up their defense. They're being implored by their coaching staff. They got to have some defense to cut into the seven-point lead.
Schwab looking. Schwab lobbing it into Mahler. Jumps up and catches it over Horn along the perimeter as he hands it back off to Schwab. Golden Bears had 5 double-digit scores against North Iowa on Tuesday. 2 so far tonight with 16 points out of Michael Joyce, 15 by Logan Nemers. Joyce underhands it out to Bauer, sidearms it across to Schwab. Schwab looking to drive, rises for a jumper, draws the contact. Late foul call, but they'll get it on Loffersweiler as Schwab will shoot two.
Loffersweiler has been burned by a couple calls here in this second half that he's not happy with. You know, he's one of those players, Tyler, that if St. Ed's is going to get themselves back in this game, I can see someone like Loffersweiler really turning it on here, starting to put some buckets in.
Schwab knocks down the free throw, and it's 51-43. Well, Bishop Garrigan is paying a ton of attention defensively to Loffersweiler. They're really making an effort to trap him in the corner every time he ventures down there on the offensive side.
Yeah, good observation there. They're really stifling him.
Schwab, second free throw, misses off to the near side, and Gallus lets it go. It's out of bounds as Schwab splits the pair.
We've seen McElroy hit a couple three-pointers this half. Gallus shows the ability to shoot as well. If St. Edmund Gales are going to shoot their way back in it, it's going to be those two guys.
Gales 3-3 so far in the season. Bishop Garrigan 5-4 as we approach winter break. 7:19 on the clock. Horn drives baseline, banging into Thomas, reversing and setting it in.
Wow, that is a move. He went 1-on-3 and still scored.
Aggressive move by Hunter Horn, and it's 51-45 as Bishop Garrigan clings to a 6-point lead. Bauer on the right wing, guarded by Gallus, gets it up top to Joyce, releases the three-pointer, left it short. Offensive board for Bauer, takes one dribble, tries to get it inside to Thomas. Ball taken away by St. Edmund, though, as Gallus has it. Far side of the court, McElroy guarded by Bauer in the backcourt as McElroy brings it across the timeline. Behind the back dribble, McElroy taking it down the lane, floats it over Thomas, and hip-to-hip contact. That'll be a foul against Bishop Garrigan as McElroy will shoot two.
Well, they're going to call Bauer. You know, Bauer really got a great rebound on the other end and then got it snatched away from him. And he's a fighter. He's not going to take that line down. And he rode that player all the way up the floor and was not going to let him get an easy bucket. He forces him to the line.
Free throw good. 51-46 as McElroy knocks down the first one. Nemers replaces Thomas for the Golden Bears.
Yeah, getting Nemers back in there. They're going to go back on offense. Get ready for the Bears to run that set play where they throw that lob into Nemers for an easy deuce.
The second free throw good as well, and that'll make it 51-47. St. Edmund has it back down to four. That is as close as they've been for most of the second half. Joyce just left the center as he's guarded by McElroy. Joyce dribbles to the left hand and backs it up to the wing of 6:35 on the clock. He'll find Schwab. Schwab to Bauer on the right side. Now back to Schwab. 19 on the shot clock. Ball poked up by Boffersweiler. Had the knockaway from Schwab, but Schwab tracks down far side. Pass into Nemers. In the post. Puts it up and puts it in.
Oh, just unstoppable.
17 points by Logan Nemers, spinning away from the defense. He's the leading scorer for Garrigan so far tonight, as it's 53-47 Golden Bears with 6:11 left. In the lane, Miracle pumps and gets it outside to McElroy. McElroy wants to drive, sees Nemers and turns around, getting it to Gallus. Gallus, 15-footer, and he rattles it into the cup.
Gallus continues to make that 15-foot jump shot look easy, and it is not. He's got 15.
15 points by Gallus so far as Joyce works the baseline and gets it out to Mahler. Gallus came in averaging 4 points per game as inside Nemers. Nemers kisses off the glass for two.
There it is again. That time the pass was from Joyce. Bear guards doing a nice job looking for Nemers inside, just like taking candy from a gale.
55-49 Bishop Garrigan, and Coach Kochendorfer wants a timeout for St. Edmund. 60-second timeout as we'll take it with him as well on KLGZ 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Elgota Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Phil's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Garrigan has led the entire second half so far, as right now they're trying to hold off St. Edmund in the fourth quarter, up 55-49 with 5:31 left. Right elbow jumper on the way, no good by McElroy, who has 14 points tonight, but couldn't knock down that 15-footer. Joyce on the left wing for Bishop Garrigan. Gets it into Nemers. Nemers back to the bucket, outside to Schwab. Rotates it to Sink. Now back inside to Mahler. Mahler finds Nemers on the opposite block, and Nemers puts it in again. 21 points, Logan Nemers.
Despite the timeout, I think the Gales, they were trying to just prevent the guards from getting the ball in, but Garrigan guards still get it done. That's 6 points in a row for Nemers, really taking over the fourth.
Yeah, Golden Bears did a nice job, too, having Mahler on the post on one side, Nemers in the post on the other side, having those two really work off each other. It's 57-49. Another foul line jumper. This one is short by Miracle. Rebound pops all the way back into the pocket of Miracle. Miracle in the lane. Passes out to left wing Waffersweiler. Catch and shoot three, in and out, and Nemers grabs the rebound. Carter Schwab into the front court now as we're down to 4:40 on the clock. Schwab to the foul line, turns around and finds Sink on the wing. Right back to Schwab, top of the key. Waffersweiler, a quick closeout. Rotation to Sink, inside to Mahler. Mahler bobbles, ball rolls away, and it's picked up by McElroy. McElroy into the front court, sidesteps Nemers, gets into the lane, kicks it out Gallus, sets himself for a three-point look, and it pops off no good as that one almost dropped back through.
Logan Nemers got to fix that knee brace before he gets out on the floor, looks for another bucket. Boy, the Gales needed that three-pointer. Now the Bears are in prime position to put up another basket, really draw this lead out to 10.
Halfway through the fourth quarter, the pass will go over the head of Mahler and out of bounds.
Oh, Mahler had a great pin up towards the elbow on his opponent. It wasn't part of their offense, but Joyce saw that he had it and thought, this is an easy bucket for Drew if I get it to him. But he rifled it through there. And Mahler didn't see it until it was a foot away from his face.
So Sandin gets the basketball back as Miracle surveys the defense. Bishop Garrigan has dropped back into his zone. They've alternated between zone and man as Coach Meister diagnosed in the pregame. Horn in the paint. Horn in traffic. Horn puts the right-hander up. It rolls off no good, and Nemers rebounds. 10 points right now by Horn. Schwab into the front court with 3:40 left as Nemers sets the screen. Schwab doesn't use it, though, so he'll hand it off to Mahler instead. Nemers trying to get position inside. Pass to the cutting sink. Sink floats it up. Shot partially tipped. It goes right to Nemers, though, and Nemers sets it in.
Well, give Trayton Sink an assist for that one, I guess. He had a nice block, or he got his shot barely blocked, and right into the hands of Nemers.
59-49, Bishop Garrigan. The backside help that Nemers attracted helped open things up that time for Sink. Even though he didn't knock it down, Nemers got the rebound as a three-point ball misses. Tracked down, though, by Horn on the far side of the court. St. Edmund with a fresh 35 and 3:07 left on the clock. Time will soon become a factor, though. Horn barreling his way in, kicks it out to McElroy. McElroy takes one dribble and hands it to Wofford-Zweiler in the corner. 3 minutes left. Wofford-Zweiler gets it back to the wing. Pass to Horn, knocked away by Mahler and taken by Sink.
Big turnover there. Nice steal by Drew Mahler.
Schwab into the front court. Schwab down the lane, left the ball behind, and here comes Horn. Horn against Joyce, one-on-one. Joyce flies by, Horn rolls it up. Shot no good as Horn rolls to the ground, balls into the bench, and it's out of bounds. Miracle couldn't save it.
Wow, goes back to Garrigan. Unbelievable. Looked like Horn was going to have an easy run out, cut the lead to 8. Michael Joyce with the speed, sprints back, challenges the shot. It rolls around and out. Unbelievable. A great hustle play, preserving this 10-point lead, Tyler, and that's big, 2:42, like you said. This is a part in the game where time's becoming an issue. The Gales have already chucked up 3 3-pointers in the last minute. They hardly shot 3 the whole game so far, and they don't seem to look too confident in wanting to take those shots.
Yeah, they're starting to feel the squeeze here in the fourth quarter, a little bit down by 10. We've rarely seen double digits at any point in this game. Garrigan got up by 13 at one point early in the second half, but St. Edmund almost immediately got back down to a four-point game, but they've inched ahead to double digits. Back to that last play, though, Joyce in transition. It was a smart play by Joyce. He knew no chance in going up and trying to block the 6'4" Horn, but all you have to do is just kind of cross in front of Horn, change the trajectory a little bit, make Horn try to avoid you and move a little bit, and that was just enough to get him off on that layup.
Yeah, he was just running interference there, and Horn was going as fast as he could, and it looks easy when we can prognosticate from 60 feet away and watch on TV and whatever we're doing, but it's hard. You're sprinting full speed straight onto the basket. No angle. He just went straight on there. That was a tough shot by Horn. So we'll see if the Bears take care of the ball in this possession, run off this 35 seconds. They can get it down to almost 2 minutes left in the game with a 10-point lead.
2:42 left in the fourth quarter. A big possession coming up for Bishop Garrigan, trying to extend. Wofford-Zweiler going for the steal against Schwab. Schwab weaves into the paint, jumps and passes the sink. Bounce pass to Mahler. Mahler tries to feed Nemers. Wofford-Zweiler recovers and intercepts. Wofford-Zweiler up the court. Wofford-Zweiler almost traveled, got it down to Horn. Power dribble, draws the foul. And Joyce prevented that shot from getting back up, but it'll be 2 free throws coming by Horn.
Yeah, probably a smart foul. That could have been an easy 2 by Horn. Just a few seconds went off the clock. Nice play by the Bears. Mahler trying to make that extra pass to Nemers. Nice set play. Just didn't happen for him. Still have the clean of that 10-point lead. 2:24 left to go in the game. Horn at the free throw line.
Horn, a 65.5% free throw shooter, and he rattles the first one home. Back down to single digits at 59-50. St. Edmund trying to avoid back-to-back losses. They lost against Iowa Falls Alden 58-54 on Tuesday as the timeout is taken by Coach Kokendorfer. We'll keep it right here of 2:24 left as St. Edmund will have 2 timeouts left after this one. In that game, Hunter Horn had 17 points and 16 rebounds. Right now, he sits at 11 after that first free throw, but once again, Garrigan involved in a close game. They were able to pull away in the second half against North Iowa on Tuesday, but it seems past few years, close games are just something that Garrigan is going to be involved with on a nearly nightly basis.
Yeah, I really thought this one was going to come down to the wire, and we still might be in for a buzzer beater. 9-point lead, still plenty of time left in the game, unless Garrigan can really take care of the ball. But sometimes when you try to take the air out of the ball and try to run the shot clock, it opens up the gate for something like what just happened to happen, a steal for a run-out layup. It doesn't always go your way. So we'll see what Coach Meister and the staff dial up here. But if they take care of the ball the rest of the way and play good, hard defense, it's looking good for the Bears. as Loffesweiler and company come up for the Gales. Horn will be at the free throw line, and McElroy and Gallus are in there. I expect them to start launching some three-pointers, Tyler.
Well, not only launching three-pointers, but on the other end, I'd expect the Gales to get more aggressive defending. You saw it recently on the last possession when Loffesweiler was really hounding Schwab and going for the steal. I'd imagine the Gales are going to start to get a little more aggressive and really try to hunt out the steal on that end of the court.
Maybe a press. If Horn makes this free throw, they might try to even press Schwab and Joyce a little bit.
We haven't seen really any pressing tonight as the free throw's in and out. Nemers grabs the rebound and it stays at a 9-point game. But that may be a good call. We might see a press coming up here soon as we're down to 2:18 left in the game. Loffesweiler defends Schwab in your half court in a battle of number 24s. Schwab gets it over to Mahler, now up top to Joyce. Left side to Schwab. Garrigan leads by 9. Sink into the post to Mahler. Mahler takes one dribble and gets it back out to Joyce. Garrigan burning plenty of time here as we're down to 2:03 left. And pass to Nemers knocked away, but it goes right to Schwab. 10 on the shot clock for Bishop Garrigan. Joyce up top. Ball poked away by McElroy, trying to force Joyce back to half court. Joyce behind the back dribble. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Mahler a 3. Mahler's got to create. Mahler squeezing between defenders. Floats it up. Missed the rim as that one just got glass. And that's a shot clock violation.
You know, they didn't get any points, but that's a little bit of a victory for the Bears. They ran the entire shot clock off. Now we only have a minute 45 left in the game, and the Gales are going to have to start fouling because it's going to take 3 just to get the Bears shooting free throws.
Yeah, just 2 team fouls by both teams so far. St. Edmund has it. Right wing three-pointer, McElroy, and he swishes it. That's a good start for the Gales, and it's 59-53.
Well, they were cold for the last couple minutes, but the rim is off for three-pointers. Here comes Joyce on the push-off again, and he's going to get called for it.
Offensive foul, Michael Joyce. Boy, that's a big call, and that's exactly what St. Edmund needed. Now beating a 3 can make it a 1-possession game. You don't necessarily need to shoot a 3 if you get a wide open 2, but if I'm the Gales, I'm at least thinking about the possibility of a 3-pointer here.
Yeah, freshman mistake by Joyce. He's a strong, physical young man, and he didn't like that player in his face, so he just pushed him off and got called for the charge.
Into the corner. It goes to Loffesweiler, drives the baseline, tries to front it to Horn. Sink intercepts the pass with 1 minute left.
Oh, huge steal by Sink. What a big play. That was going to be 2 points till Sink stepped in there.
And now when will St. Edmund foul? Schwab is in the corner. They're going for the steal right now. Loffesweiler forces Schwab to pivot about 5 times, and Bishop Garrigan is going to call a timeout. Golden Bears have 2 left.
Whoa.
Schwab spun, and he spun, and he spun, and he spun. And I'm surprised he's not puking over there on the Garrigan bench right now.
He was spinning, waiting for someone to foul him because they knew they were going to come and foul because, as we said, Tyler, they've got to foul 3 more times just to get the Bears shooting free throws. There's 24 seconds on the shot clock, so if the Bears can probably run this clock out, even with the fouls, you know, they get fouled every 6 seconds. They're going to pretty much run down this shot clock playing keep away. And then you're going to be left with about 20 seconds left in this game where the Bears are going to be shooting free throws. So we're, I don't know, I'm wishfully thinking as a Bear fan that we're just going to be in a free throw contest for the rest of this game.
And rebounding going to be big as well. Bishop, if you're Bishop Garrigan, you got to force St. Edmund to be one and done if they miss any shots. Don't want to give up any second chance opportunities here.
Boy, that steal by Sink a second ago was so huge. They tried to do an extra interior pass. They tried to bounce pass it in the paint, and Sink just snuck right in there and grabbed the ball. If they hit that bucket, and it's 59-55, completely different framework here. But now the Bears, they're going to have a box formation. They got 4 guys down low. Schwab inbounding it.
6-point advantage by Bishop Garrigan. Joyce gets it over to Sink. Mahler trying to post up inside his Sink, works it around the perimeter and hands it off to Schwab. 45 seconds left of the game clock, 16 on the shot clock. St. Edmund will have to foul eventually.
They tried to foul Joyce right there, and they didn't get called.
Schwab driving in. Schwab finds Mahler. Mahler puts it off the glass, and there's 2.
Wow, St. Ed's trying to foul, not getting it called.
5 points by Drew Mahler, 61-53 Bishop Garrigan. Now a double-team trap on Gallus in the corner. His entry pass knocked away by Nemers and stolen by Joyce. Now 22 seconds left, and Bishop Garrigan in a great spot into the front court with Joyce. And St. Edmund may be waving the white flag here, and they will. Bishop Garrigan is going to run the time off the clock, and the final 10 seconds will tick away. Bishop Garrigan is going to head into winter break with a Christmas present, a victory, and be 2 games above 500. 61-53, the final score at the Golden Bear High School Gymnasium as the final buzzer sounds. Bishop Garrigan outlasts St. Edmund in this one.
Great win for the Bears here. Good game, good solid game. Lots of adjustments made on the fly. Great adjustments by Garrigan there, defensively, offensively. Good plays at big moments for the Bears. Got to be a big shot in the arm this week. Huge win against North Iowa and a good solid win against a good Gales team here.
So we'll step aside for one quick timeout and come back with the final scoring numbers and analysis after this on Home Country KLGZ.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Purple Ding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Purple Ding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Bishop Garrigan enters winter break with a win over St. Edmond. Golden Bears now 6-4 on the season as St. Edmond drops to 3-4. Final count in this game, 61-53 in favor of the Golden Bears. The scoring by quarter went like this. St. Edmond grabbed a 16-13 lead after the first quarter. Golden Bears, though, had a 21-10 scoring advantage in the second, their highest scoring quarter of the game, to go up 34-26 into halftime. St. Edmond got 1 point closer in the third quarter. They outscored Bishop Garrigan 17-16 to make the score 50-43. Golden Bears going into the fourth, but the Golden Bears outscored the Gales 11-10 in the fourth quarter, winning this one 61-53. Individual scoring leaders look like this. For Bishop Garrigan, Logan Nemers had 23 points, a lot of that in the second half. Michael Joseph, 16, Carter Schwab of 9, and Amari Thomas with 7. On the St. Edmund side of things, three double-digit scores. Jack McElroy had 17 points, Grant Gallus had 16, Hunter Horn of 11, and Bishop Garrigan was able to hold Sam Miracle to just 5 points as Miracle came in averaging over 13 per game. And again, 61-53, the final score in this one. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie. Beanie, the game before winter break is always an unpredictable one as a basketball coach, because obviously all coaches like to think their team's dialed in and ready to go, but you're dealing with the human element of winter break's coming up, classes are ending, we can exhale, but you can't exhale with the final basketball game on the schedule. And Golden Bears, they held on in the end, they did enough to win this one and executed pretty well as far as running the clock late in that fourth quarter.
Yeah, like, not just the players. People in general are just accelerated into the Christmas mode. There's a lot of alumni back. Garrigan honored all of their Wall of Fame. The people that earned, I think, 8 letters or more get honored at this halftime every year. So they were all back at halftime. So a lot of those parents are back. And everyone just wants to start the holidays and talk to friends and relatives. It's really fun seeing kids come back from college every year and alumni come back for that. But, yes, try to get your focus on the game is a challenge on the game before Christmas. But they successfully pulled it off here. Bears had a nice game today. They really took advantage of what the Gales were giving them, and that was Logan Nemers inside. Gales had no answer for Logan Nemers. He had to be close to his season high on that point total, I imagine. But, yeah, he was tough inside. He couldn't be stopped. He did really, really well.
Yeah, Logan Nemers ended up with 23 points tonight, the leading scorer for Bishop Garrigan. And this certainly was a game that was played inside of the paint. St. Edmund as well, their 3-point total look a little bit higher than Garrigan's, because St. Edmund took a few a few late threes to try to get back into the game. But both these teams really made a concerted effort to try to get the ball into the paint. St. Edmund did a little differently than Garrigan. It was a lot of jumpers from the paint, some 10 to 15 foot jump shots, which they were actually quite proficient at. And for Garrigan, it was touch after touch for Logan Nemers inside, because like you said, Nemers really didn't miss too many of those opportunities, and St. Edmund didn't have a whole lot of answer for him. So that's a really good performance by Bishop Garrigan. And again, you can slowly feel this team starting to find their identity. They've won 4 of the last 5 games. Obviously, still a few things to work on going into winter break. But at this point, you've beaten 3 top of Iowa West teams. You get a win over a North Central Conference team in St. Edmund tonight. And your only loss in that stretch is against an Algona team that went to state last year.
Right. They're looking a lot more comfortable, as predicted. You know, they're getting better every game out there. Really had some nice teamwork tonight. A lot of extra passes for the open player. They didn't get limited offensively. And some big defensive stops there at the right times in the game where they really needed it. Well done for the Bears. And now the Christmas break. And now we have to start talking about post-break, but we're not ready to do that yet, Tyler. We got to just enjoy this break. Well earned by you in the broadcast booth, doing a lot of games lately, Tyler. You're keeping us all informed. We appreciate it.
That's right. But we're going to keep it going after winter break, folks, because Bishop Garrigan plays Forest City on January 2nd. You may be ready to relax, people listening at home. But
Did you say January 2nd?
January 2nd.
Wow. That's
get ready to
already?
Bring in 2024 with top of Iowa West basketball action.
I guess so.
That's going to be a great doubleheader, folks, because on the girls' side, Forest City and Bishop Garrigan are both undefeated in conference play. On the boys' side, there's a serious logjam at the top of the conference because North Union beat Lake Mills the other day and ended Lake Mills' top of Iowa West winning streak. So if you look at conference records only, North Union's 5-1. Lake Mills is 5-1, Garrigan's 4-2, Eagle Grove's 4-2, and by the way, Forest City's 5-1. So those top few teams of the conference are so bunched up. This second half of the year is going to be absolutely crazy in boys basketball.
Wow, that is going to be exciting. You know what this means? If this Forest City matchup coming for both the boys and girls on January 2nd, it's going to be some hard practices over Christmas break. They better not eat too many sweets on Christmas Day because it's going to be a rough coming back to the gym on the 27th, I believe, is when we could start things up again. Good luck, players.
That's right. Everyone better gear up. But in the meantime, everyone enjoy your winter holiday and enjoy the winter break for those of you who are still in school at this point. Beanie, enjoy your winter break as well. We'll see you in Forest City on January 2nd.
Thank you, Tyler. I hope the road back to Ohio to see your family is nice and clear.
Yes, I'm hoping for the same thing as well. So that'll wind it down for us tonight, folks. This has been a sports production of Home Country Radio KLGZ. Once again, the final score, Bishop Garrigan 61 and St. Edmund 53.